What is going on, everyone? Jax here, and I am at a very, very wet Michelin Road Atlanta Raceway with Lexus Performance Driving School, where we're going to be doing, well, a whole lot of driving. We're going to be taking these LCs around the track. We've got an autocross with the IS 500, which I've been dying to drive. And then we're going to be on the skidpad with the RCF. And I'm going to take you along for the ride. I don't know if you guys can hear me because I'm on the GoPro, but we're about to do a braking exercise at Road Atlanta. We're gonna go 100% throttle and then 100% brake. And I'm imagining you'll be able to tell by my face and general demeanor when that happens. Also, 6'6" with a helmet on, pretty tight fit in the LC 500.
Next car ready for you.
All right, so first exercise down. Sounds like my teammates did a pretty good job. We are on teams here, so I'm a pretty competitive person. I would very much like to win, whatever that looks like or form it takes, but I'd like to win. All right, so the second braking exercise is on the, like, chicane here at Road Atlanta. It is a pretty intense, like, 90-degree left-hander that we're hitting.
All right, next car. Okay, let's go. Full throttle, full throttle. Good job.
Woo!
Yeah, much better, everyone. That second run was just way better.
Oh, man. I would say that's some good confidence in the wet because it is really wet out here. All right, so we just completed the braking test, which was interesting in the rain. You don't think these cars can stop that quickly when it's pouring down rain out here, but I can assure you they can. Now we're gonna go out for a lead follow. So I'm watching the first group go out, and then we're gonna go out with instructors and do like a lead follow lap that they describe as walking, but I have a sneaking suspicion that I won't think it's walking. I'll probably think it's full on Olympic sprinting, but to them, it's just a walk in the park. All right, doing the lead follow
once
now.
Once you're here, you can feed the power. You can accelerate up this hill, aiming for that second tree. Let's do it. A little closer, car one. Just bring everybody up a little bit and let's do it. Angle down and just straight shot through. You'll get a little bit of hydroplaning, but the straighter you'll do it, the better off you'll be. Keep it to the right to set up for five. Because this radio makes a lot more sense when you're on pole position number one. So we'll keep rotating it all day, gentlemen. You're rocking around nine. You're just got your eyes peeled looking for the blue brake cones. You can't see them until you're almost at them because of the hill. It's a big arc as I can make it out towards the grass, but obviously not getting on it. Late turn in. Still late. Close to the, you'd be next to the curve if it was dry, but close because you see the puddle. You'd be snug against it if it was dry. And all the way out to the left. Perfect. Car one, you stay to the left this time. Two and three are going to come by full throttle path. Come on by, guy. And that bad boy up. Yeah, I think that tells you to punch it twice. Let it rip.
All right, that felt pretty good. That felt really good. It was easy peasy in the LC 500.
Car stay running the whole time.
There's a lot of time still on the table here. Man, I wish I had some external GoPros. All right, next. All right, so didn't have a ton of time at lunch because we're running a little bit behind schedule with the inclement weather. So we're going back down to the big track. I am gonna try to hook up the GoPro for this, but in this whirlwind sort of track day tour, we're going back down to the big track for more aggressive lead follow laps, which sounds utterly fantastic, especially now that it's not raining. So stay tuned, and if I'm back, I survived, and if not, RIP, it was a good run. Going out again, this time lead follow even faster. The goal is to get fast.
All right, gentlemen, let's do it. Pacing, car one, you're perfect off of me and everybody else. Got two car lengths, be perfect. Let's do it. As you can arc up here, you can see the cones, arc it in nice and straight for a quick little shot of the brakes. Do the right-hander, you'll go.
all the track out.
One, just stay to the left. Two and three are going to pass you. Come on by, two and three. Full throttle pass. It's a late, late turn, and you got to take it down to the orange cone that I'm caught in hiding in front of you. Turn it in nice and smooth. Get it to the bottom apron. Hug that apron. As you start to go up the hill, you can feel on the power. Hit the tree number two on the right. As soon as you can see the cones, mark it in for your brake zone. Cars ahead of you have a big head start. You're still running them down. Look for the brake zone here on the left. It's a late turn in. Almost everything's a late turn in.
Full bottom, guys. Hammer down.
I gotta twist your arm to crank it up. Rates the men from the boys. Comes time to qualifying.
Well, we took it a little bit more seriously there.
12.
Not really a lot of time for talking when you're
excellent
on
start.
A
nice,
track
nice.
Like
obviously,
Road Atlanta.
Super smooth in your marks. I like this.
All right, guys, so we just finished our first round of the autocross, and I couldn't put the GoPro in the car, A, because I didn't have time, and B, because it would have been kind of distracting. There's not as much space up front in the IS500, which is what we're using on the autocross, but the rain is starting to let up, fingers crossed. So through the magic of editing, I will try to bring you some of the vehicles that are here, and Lexus LFA. Just pulled in. All right, well, the rain is coming down again pretty significantly. About to head out for the last run of the day on the big track. I think it's actually gonna be our last run on the big track, period, before we go over to the skid pad, which should be a lot of fun. Challenge accepted. They wanna see who can do a donut all the way around. I'm gonna try to do one. Probably not, but we'll see. So we're gonna see how this run goes with the rain coming down as much as it is, but the confidence is going up. The more we run this track, the more comfortable it feels. But as they just said, when do you get into trouble? On the last run of the day, so we're not gonna go too crazy. I just learned a very important piece of information. I'm not too bad at driving, but I am trash at drifting a car. They tried to teach me, and it was honestly like teaching a dolphin to walk. It was terrible, but it was a lot of fun. And that's what matters, and I'm humble enough to admit that I suck at something, many things, but this is also one of them I'm adding to the list. Well, I just completed my final round of the autocross course, and I have to admit something. I have to admit something to you here. I've let you down. I hit a cone on my last run, got docked 5 seconds, but you know what? It's okay, because I was trying to go full send, and this today has just been an absolute blast, and this autocross was a great way to wrap things up, and I'm really proud of the times I was throwing down, considering, you know, I have a lot of experience doing this. This is a lot of fun. Well, so that wraps up the, I guess, the events of today. And we wrapped it up with a hot lap from professional race car driver and like multi-champion of so many races, Scott Pruett, who was here teaching us for Lexus. And here's some footage of that.
Oh,
yeah, the last one. Yes.
Yeah, and to sort of put that into context, he did that with four people in the car and was over a second faster than the fastest person that could go around the autocross here. So with an extra, 500 pounds of ballast in the IS 500, he easily smoked us, and every single one of his times was within about 0.2 of a second on 5 or 6 laps. So insane abilities. I'm kind of digging the LX 600 in person. I know when it came out, people were all like talking about the grill and stuff like that, but like, I'm kind of digging this thing, man, to be honest with you. This is a good looking giant luxury SUV, and I want to get behind the wheel of one. So Lexus, I'm ready. I'm ready when you are. All right, guys, that is a wrap on a freaking amazing day. I hope I did a good job bringing that to you, or at least trying to. It was hard because we were in the cars most of the time, and the best I could do in the cars was put up a GoPro. I do think there's going to be some external video of this that maybe I can pull because there was a production team out here. But in any case, I hope you enjoyed this quick video on the Lexus Performance Driving School here at Michelin Raceway Road, Atlanta. And I hope you'll tune in next time for the next video. Make sure to like, subscribe if you thought this was fun. Ride safe, drive safe. I will see you in the next video. All right, peace. All right, so round two, hot laps. It started pouring rain again. Awesome. Goal remains, don't die. Yeah, I don't want to brag, but we keep catching the first group because we're so awesome.
All right, let's roll into the power. Let's do it. Have fun, be safe.
So that run in the wet was probably as fast as anything that we've done so far.
See what we have for time. We might be able to get back out again. I'll check with Ernie.
It's a good improvement, to be honest with you. You just sense the confidence build as you just get used to lapping. So pouring rain, and we did better on that than we did on the last one.